And
thank you for having me. Gary, we met about a year ago here in Des Moines, like in the Colbert Report. I thank you for that.
Person for the issue. Basically, the 25 years in prison for intent to distribute marijuana to his daughter, if I'm remembering this correctly.
Yeah.
And that
yep.
is abominable. That makes me want to cry. I am outraged about that beyond words.
Well, what a waste of taxpayer money, too.
Well, what actually happens, my daughter was found with a gram of marijuana in her purse. And they never actually, I didn't give marijuana to my daughter, but I had my own marijuana. And because I had marijuana and she did, I got 25 years for the, I guess, because we both had marijuana. I mean, I didn't actually give her the marijuana. But they didn't actually have to show that link or anything, which is kind of crazy.
And, you know,
I see it. I understand it, and I'm afraid that yours is an example that that hundreds of thousands of others, I'm afraid, have fallen into that same situation, and it's an outrage.
Yeah. You know, and I'm very active in the political system. I lobby just on my own. I'm not paid by anybody, but I agree with a lot of things you say, and I definitely on the liberal side. But I would have to say, if you won the nomination, you would definitely get my vote. No doubt about that.
Well, I appreciate that. Thank you, and I appreciate your story, and I just want to apologize for a system that needs to be fixed.
Mike, thank you for the call.
Thank you.
Appreciate it. So, real quick on foreign policy, Gary. I mean,
email GaryJohnson 2012. I would like to. That's what the company.
We run out of time, Gary.
Email GaryJohnson 2012. I'd like to make further contact and just clarify some of this stuff, and actually perhaps get you as a spokesperson for the issue. Basically, Mike was sentenced to 25 years in prison for intent to distribute marijuana to his daughter, if I'm remembering this correctly.
Yeah.
And that is abominable. That makes me want to cry. I am outraged about that beyond words.
Well, what a waste of taxpayer money, too.
Well, what actually happens, my daughter was found with a gram of marijuana in her purse. And they never actually, I didn't give marijuana to my daughter, but I had my own marijuana. And because I had marijuana and she did, I got 25 years for the, I guess, because we both had marijuana. I mean, I didn't actually give her the marijuana. But they didn't actually have to show that link or anything, which is kind of crazy.
And you know,
I see it. I understand it, and I'm afraid that yours is an example that that hundreds of thousands of others, I'm afraid, have fallen into that same situation. And it's
Ray. Good morning.
Hey, good morning. Congratulations on year one, guys.
What are you doing up so early?
I was listening to you guys. I was wake up about 5:45 right before I came to
you. You smoke a bowl right when you get up?
Not right away.
How long do you wait till you smoke a bowl?
Well, half hour.
Half hour?
Yeah, after I have some coffee.
So as soon as you hang up, you're gonna toke one up.
Oh, in celebration of being back on TNT in the morning.
Because you were banned for a little bit.
Yeah, I was. You know, and
I think I overreacted with you. So you know, and I apologize for that. If I'm gonna apologize for one thing over the last year, it's because I overreacted with you.
Well, you know, it's your guys' show that brought me out of retirement to calling into local sports radio.
Is that right? So we're not your only show that you call?
Well, no, I used to call in a lot, you know, back, you know, days in the afternoon, all that, Sound Off with Keith and Murph.
Yeah.
Sunday nights, all that. But I just want to give a shout-out to Sean for mentioning me the other day, and I wondered what was waiting for his stat on how many times you guys talked about me without even me calling in.
Oh, that's true. That's probably pretty high. You have to come up
yeah,
with that
like
stat. And I shouldn't
that's
say the word high around you, but it's probably last because you know. Do you subscribe to High Times, Ray?
No.
Okay.
But congratulations! I'm going to call back and throw somebody on the bus or in the penalty box.
Now you know it's the
penalty.
Right. Get it right.
Throw
you know
in
that.
The penalty box.
Yeah.
You know we expect that from you, Ray. I mean, if there's one guy we expect it from, because you are probably the most regular listener.
Hey, Travis.
Yeah.
One morning, me and Johnny was going to come down there in the parking lot at KXNO and wait for you to come in. But then I realized you don't even...
You'd be waiting a long time, brother.
That would be the morning that you're not here, I'm not here, nobody's here.
All right, Ray.
All right.
Ray, thanks.
All right. We'll have the Pineapple Express.
Exactly.
Should we fire the alarm
call? It calls every day.
Is there a Chuck that calls? I don't even pay attention. Is there a Chuck that... Ray usually calls every day, but he's usually trying to sell us weed. There is
a Chuck. TNT show 1460 AM. It's actually on there too. You could click on there. There's a link.
Oh, so you're the one who has our Twitter account.
Yeah, I'm the lawyer.
All right, Sean.
News billboard.
What's that?
I did a billboard of you guys too, to change your guys' actual pictures.
Oh, did you?
Pictures on you. Yeah.
Man.
You know, you're still not following me though.
I'm not.
I will have.
I will follow you. I promise
I'll
you.
I'll go do that right now.
And Rev and Ray, a shout out.
All right,
Sean. Thanks for the call.
Chuck, Ray usually calls every day, but he's usually trying to sell us weed. There is. No.